have been training our 5 Arapaima for some very specific behaviors. We're hoping to train them to eventually voluntarily enter a stretcher, you know, a sling, just like you might use on an injured person, so that we can get some health information from them, do blood draws, get weights. And in that process, we've had to teach them more than one behavior to build up to that end goal. We're also trained to station, which is that we lower a bucket lid, that's their signal, come to this location, and if you stay at this location, you'll be rewarded. And that helps us get 5 of them over to one side, which helps us make sure that we can control who is participating in the rest of the training behaviors, but it also helps us get them out of the way of the divers who are feeding at the same time. Whereas stationing an animal is asking them to stay in one spot, target can be used to move an animal from one spot to another. That is the behavior that we're most using to build up to this stretcher behavior, to enter the stretcher, because I'm asking the Arapaima to come and target, come and touch this pole, basically, and then I can move the pole a little bit, ask them to touch it again, they'll swim forward, and eventually work on leading them in through all the way into the stretcher. They are very big, heavy, muscular animals, and it would be very difficult and potentially dangerous for us to have to attempt to net one. I'm not even sure if we have a net large enough and strong enough for them. They're also very intelligent, as it turns out, and very food motivated. And when you're training animals, if you put together intelligence, even limited intelligence, and food motivation, you really have a great start for successful training. So right now, what we're doing is hanging the equipment into sort of a J shape. So we're getting them used to the actual equipment that they're going to be used if we get them into a stretcher. And we are slowly changing the shape of that equipment to look like the stretcher shape that is going to be used on the day that they would go into a stretcher. The whole process is a lot of small steps that come together to eventually lead us to our overall goal. So we're taking lots of little baby steps, waiting for the animals to feel comfortable with that part, and then moving them a little bit forward, waiting for them to get comfortable, moving forward. We want to continue getting them comfortable with the stretcher and the equipment, and continue to make it look more and more like how it's actually going to be hanging in the water the day that they would go into the stretcher at the end of the training.